In this video, I'm going to share with you how to update your Pro Tools. So first, we need to make sure the Avid link is open. And we'll see that the Avid link likes to hide itself if you're in dark mode. There it is. So we're going to go up here, click show, and we'll want to log in. So make sure you click on profile. Now, I have always found the Avid link incredibly slow. So give it a sec. And then we can log in. Once we're in, we're going to go to products. Should we give it a second again? If you find it's not updating, then you can just does this sign in. So we'll just wait a minute while it syncs. But you can always click reload to get it to resync. And once that's synchronized, you can have it just show you your updates. So I've got two updates. If Avid Link needs updating, I recommend doing that first. It just makes sense. If that's the installer app, make sure that's up to date first. We're going to update that. Click through all the buttons. So I want to close the Avid Link. Once the Avid Link's installed, we can reopen it, or it reopens itself. Look, they managed to update that little little thing where the icon was black. So we'll click show. It now has this new, allows you to sort of install from the app itself. So you just need to put in your system username and your system password and then agree to the license agreement. You don't have to do that. You can click use extended install. Here, so we'll click that. It's a bit bigger. Let's go back to our products, and again, we'll wait for it to synchronize. Just show the updates. So it says there's a new version of Pro Tools update, and it will download all of the different packets that are required. We can click in here to see all of the different bundles that are attached to Pro Tools itself. Plugins, and you've got some demo stuff. We'll just click back and wait for this to download, and then we'll get that installed. And once that's installed, we can turn this off, and we can see I have two versions of Pro Tools now. It's split them in two. So yeah, we can then go ahead and we can open our Pro Tools. So you might need to go through and reauthorize your subscription or your Pro Tools license. If you've got an iLock, make sure that's plugged in. If you've got a cloud license, make sure you go through this process, put in your details, activate your cloud session. When you reinstall a new version of Pro Tools, it does go through and rescan all of the plugins. So just give it the time it needs. You might need to plug or unplug in some iLocks. Or if you've got USB licenses for your waves, you make sure that those are plugged in. But yeah, on a new install, it's going to rescan. So just give it all the time it needs. And there we are. Pro Tools updated and ready to go.